you. Today we will discuss math topic in Maths Geometry of chapter 15. In this topic, today we will discuss about shape, size and properties of the geometrical concept. As you know that today we will discuss about geometrical concept, and in previous years you have learned about the geometrical concept. Today I will recall about some points. So here in this geometrical figure, these are the basic concept of the geometrical geometry. So these are the figures, these are the shapes of the geometrical concepts. First plane. What plane? A plane is a definite a plane is a flat surface and it extends endlessly, and it can be extended endlessly on the surface, on the flat surface. That kind the plane. Let us here, plane is in the form of triangle, in the form of square, in the form of rectangle. A plane is a flat surface. This is a flat surface on the because here the board, this one board is also a flat. It is in the form of rectangle shape. Yes or no? So here this I talked about some points of the plane, triangle, square and rectangle. These are the flat surface, the flat figures of the plane. Next one point, second point. What is a point? A point has a dot-like structure. A point has a dot. And on the flat surface, a point is a dot-like structure, a point on the flat surface. It has no length, no breadth. It has no length, breadth or height. Because point has no length, breadth or height. Only this is a point. Mark on any place. It has no length, breadth or height. Next one, third point, collinear point. What is a collinear point? In here, if three or more than three points, this one point, A point, this one B point, this one C point. If three or more than three point, no problem, three also reaching this point, B point. Yes, if three or more than three points, if they meet at their meet lies, they lie on the same plane, they lie on the same plane. That are called the collinear points. As you know that if four points are there, A, thus here A, B, C and D. These are the four points. Lies on the same plane, same lines. A point on the, this one is the line. This one is the line. All these four points on lies on the line. Not upper or lower side of the line. On the line. These four points are on the lies of the when three or more than three points, if they do not meet या they do not lie on the same plane, that are called the non-collinear points. Because if we take three points A, B and C, take three points, but they do not lie on the same line. Because A and B and C point, these are the lines. These are the points lies on two points only lies on the plane. Line. Two points lies on the line. But third point does not lies on the line. So these are called the non-collinear points. Because here three or more than three lines. Three or more than three lines. If any one line, any one point, two point, they do not meet. That's why non-collinear points. Here a line. In lines, a line, a collection of a line in a straight line with no endpoints. Because a line has no endpoints. A line has no endpoint. It can be extended endlessly on the both directions. Both the directions. In this side, it can be extended on this one side and this one also. In both the directions. Line can be extended on both the directions. And its length can be measured. Its length cannot be measured. Its length cannot be measured. A line, the length of the line cannot be measured. But it is noted by, it is named as simply L and S arrow gesture. Line and arrow. These are the line of the figure. And here, lines are different. A collection of lines in a straight line. Or in a straight line, here this one is a straight line. In here, with a fixed end point. Because there are two end points. One is this, one is this. So simply, we can say that a line has two end points. It cannot be extended. Because it is a fixed. It is a fixed. And its length can be measured. Its length can be measured. And it is noted by the form of cosine 2 and point R. One is this one point, the second is this point. Both these two points measure. So we can say here, we can written here AB and here line is this one. Symbol of the line segment is this. And after that, next point, ray. What is a ray? A ray has one as a fixed point and another as a no end point. So we can say that a ray has a one end point. A ray has a one end point. One is a fixed point. And another one is not a fixed. Another one point is endless. And it can be extended. So here, in this form, we can say written here, OA is a ray. OA is a ray. Because one is a fixed point and another one is not a fixed point. So we can say written here like this. OA and symbol of the ray is this one. One type arrow. Because one point is fixed and another point is not fixed. In parallel lines. Parallel means two lines. Parallel, but they do not meet. When we can say simply that when two lines, what they do not, when two lines away from a direction, what they do not meet at any point, at any common points, at any common point, when two lines they do not meet at any common points, they are not, they do not meet, they are parallel, like an example railway track. Railway track is a good example of the parallel line, because railway track does not meet, they can be parallel. So here the symbol of the parallel line is like this. Next one, intersecting line when two lines meet at any common point O. Yeah, no problem. At any both the point. No problem here. When two lines meet at any common points. When any line they meet at any common points, that are called intersecting lines. Because A, B and C, D are the two lines meet at a common point that are called intersecting line. These two lines are intersecting line, meet at point O. O is the common point of these two lines. Next here, perpendicular lines. When two lines meet at an angle of 90 degree, so these two lines are called perpendicular lines. Here, when two lines, one is AB and another one is CD. Two lines meet at point at an angle here of 90 degree. At an angle of 90 degree form an angle, 90 degree form an angle, 90 degree. At point O, this one point meet at this point, that this is for perpendicular, that is 90 degree. So this is the symbol of perpendicular, is this one. They always form 90 degree. Perpendicular also form 90 degree.